Now, will someone listen to me? James Bulger's mother slams probation services for covering up for vile, perverted psychopath John Venables after he was caught with child porn for the second time. James Bulger's mother Denise has accused the probation service of covering up for vile, perverted psychopath John Venables, who was back in jail again after being caught with child porn. The killer was arrested and imprisoned a week ago, the second time since his release, but Ms. Fergus was only told last night. She said today, "I predicted Venables would re-offend unless they kept a very tight rein on him, and I pray that now, someone from the UK government will finally listen to me." Venables and Robert Thompson were 10 when they abducted 2-year-old James outside a brutal butcher's before torturing and murdering him and dumping him on a railway track in 1993. James' mother says she is absolutely fuming about her treatment and said, "Once again, I'm the last to know." She said, "Venables has now proved beyond any doubt was a vile, perverted psychopath he has always been. But what hurts me most is the way the probation service has tried to cover this up. Venables was taken back into custody a week ago, yet I was only informed hours before it hit the press. But it's clear that they were trying to keep this quiet, until they got a call from the media. They then phoned me last night at 8:40 p.m., in a hurried call, with few details given, just that he had breached his terms of the license and returned to prison. That left me extremely upset, angry and feeling insulted. I will be taking advice from my lawyer before making a formal complaint to the probation service. I hope finally I might get some justice for my son James." Venables, now 35, was arrested last week after officials making a routine visit to his home discovered the sickening images on his computer and alerted police. It is the second time that the murderer has been put back behind bars, having been caught with a large hoard of child porn in 2010. The killer's new identity is protected by a lifelong anonymity order and has been changed 4 times since his release in 2001, costing taxpayers £250,000 each time, and around £5 million in total has been spent trying to rehabilitate him. His arrest has led to calls for him never to be released again, and a source close to the family said, "The question has now to be asked whether he has finally run out of chances." The Sun reported that Venables was rushed to a maximum security prison, which cannot be identified for legal reasons. A source told the newspaper, "Every expense has been afforded him, every expert opinion offered, every opportunity given. And yet here we are again. If he is found to have committed a new offense, then why should the public continue to pay through the nose to protect his anonymity any longer?" Venables is now being held for breaching the lifelong license he and Robert Thompson were given after the brutal torture and murder of James Bulger in 1993. Venables, who has not yet been charged with any offense, and Thompson were both 10 years old when they shocked Britain by abducting James, then just 2 years old. The crime made the boys the youngest killers in modern English history and public enemy number one with millions of Brits. The duo snatched Bulger from outside a butcher's shop in Bootle, Merseyside, in 1993, while his mother popped into a store for just a few seconds. The toddler's mutilated body was found on a railway line in Walton, Liverpool, 2 days later. Venables and Thompson were found guilty of killing Bulger in November 1993 and were sentenced to custody until they reached 18. They were freed in 2001 after serving 8 years behind bars, but by 2010 Venables was back in prison for violating the terms of his release by possessing child porn. It was revealed that he had downloaded and distributed more than 100 images of child abuse, some involving victims as young as 2 being raped. In one instance, he messaged another pedophile claiming to be a married mother who abused her 8-year-old daughter, and offered to sell access to the child. He was freed from prison for the second time in 2013 after a recommendation from the parole board. At the time, Denise and Ralph Bulger said they were filled with terror by the decision to grant parole to Venables. Mr. Bulger said, "It is only a matter of time before he caves into his lust for young children again. John Venables is and always was a predatory sex killer who will never be changed. He will always be a danger to children, which is why he must be locked up for life." After Venables's conviction for child porn, a review discovered he had regularly breached a condition of his original release that he must not go back to Merseyside. The probe said he would certainly have been returned to Gael sooner if officials had known his movements, which could have been monitored by a satellite tag. Under strict rules put in place following his release from prison, the murderer has lifelong anonymity, meaning anyone he speaks to online will not know about his past. Only a tight-knit cabal operating under conditions of extreme secrecy are allowed to know who he really is. Under the terms of his lifelong license, one or two senior probation officers regularly visit Venables to ensure he is adhering to the conditions of his release. The terms include a ban on traveling to Merseyside, and he also faces restrictions on accessing the internet. Venables was given his first new identity when he was jailed in 1993, and a second when he was released from a sentence of indefinite imprisonment in 2001, aged 18. In May 2011, his name and background was changed once again after a serious breach in the security of the identity he had been using. In 2013, officials said they would not give him another identity because he could not be trusted to keep it secret. But they were forced to change their minds amid mounting fears for his safety if he is ever outed. Pictures purporting to be of Venables were circulated on the internet in 2013, despite an injunction granting him lifetime anonymity.